Dear colleagues, at the outset, I on my own and behalf of the group wish each one and all your family a very happy and prosperous New Year 2016. I also extend a warm welcome to you all on this winter afternoon. The New Year is not only the time to celebrate our accomplishments and the milestones crossed, but to explore new horizons and set up new dreams. At the beginning of every year, when we gather here, we take stock of our achievements in the year gone by, particularly in the context of the challenges we faced in achieving them. We also take this opportunity to dedicate ourselves to the tasks of the year ahead. Looking back, one of the outstanding milestones of the year was that we doubled our turnover over the last 5 years in line with the vision we had set out for ourselves. This was achieved on the strength of substantial capital expenditure across our businesses, which exceeded rupees 5,000 crores, more importantly, reflecting our firm belief in India's growth story. These investments were made in a period when economic and policy conditions were challenging and when most Indian business houses chose to keep their investments on hold. This growth has further cemented our businesses and their reach in over 100 countries around the world. This achievement is particularly a celebration of contributions of all of you in the group who have worked with commitment and dedication to meet these goals. I firmly believe that this is greatly enabled by our effort in caring for our people and recognizing their contribution. These efforts are inseparable part of our group's value. I'm sure that each one of you will continue to dedicate yourself to this spirit, which goes a long way towards making a lasting impact on the organization and the society at large. Harmonious industry relations continue to be another hallmark of the year gone by. Simultaneously, we continue to work on several initiatives for developing our employees to ensure their career growth and to strengthen their contribution to group businesses. In recognition of these initiatives, our companies were awarded the CII HR Excellence Award, Great Place to Work Award, Green Turf, and many more. The year 2015 it returned as a year of growth and a year of quality for our businesses. Our people, be they in manufacturing, marketing, finance, procurement or HR, brought about commendable improvements and excellence in the operations. This effort has helped us win several national and international awards, including those of Kaizen and Quality Service. I now take this opportunity to briefly reflect on the performance of our group companies in the year 2015. JK Tyre and Industries, pioneer of radial tyres in India, continue to maintain its leadership position and have now become the preferred suppliers of several OEs across product ranges. Its recent acquisition of Luskar Haridwar unit of Birla Tyres is a major milestone which will further strengthen its position, besides giving the company an entry into the fast-growing two- and three-wheeler tire market. JK Paper Limited achieved the best-ever performance in the year 2014-15 by crossing a turnover of 2,500 crores. In spite of higher raw material prices and limitations of pricing the finished goods due to import, we stood our ground and introduced more high-value products in the market, which has been well accepted. To ensure smooth raw material availability and enhance green cover, JK Paper has been planting trees on large tracts of land over period. And in this year of 2015 alone, it planted more than 8 crore trees. JK Paper now is a net green company by planting more number of trees than it uses for production of paper. JK Lakshmi Cement continues its envious leadership position of being the lowest cost producer in the cement industry. Our efforts for increased customer satisfaction and higher customer loyalty based on superior products and services gives us superior brand position in the market. Our new branding units at Gujarat and East and the new Lingarajan facility in Udaipur will soon get commissioned. These will take our capacity to nearly 12 million tons, a matter of satisfaction for the group considering that the capacity was about 5 million tons only 2 years back. JK Fenner India Limited continues to be market leader in power transmission belts. JK Fenner oil seals, hoses, vibration dampers, and all well are well accepted in the market. The company's thrust in global market continues as it moves forward confidently on this trajectory of growth. JK Agrigenetics is an R&D-led seed development company that serves the farming community to meet their productive challenges and increase their in continuously researches and develops hybrid, genetically modified and non-genetically modified seeds of various crops like cotton, rice, jowar, bajra, maize and vegetables that are distributed through more than 40,000 retailers across the country. Global Strategic Technologies, one of our new businesses, has been set up to meet defense requirements. It has taken on its role, DELOC, which was established in the year 2000 by an ex-DRDO scientist. DELOC specializes in design and development of embedded electronics and electro-optical systems and is increasingly developing various systems of Indian light aircraft, Tejas, main battle tank, Arjun, and several missiles and tactical systems. It has received a number of quality certifications in the year. GST is our initiative to the government's thrust of Make in India in the defense sector. Umang Dairies is one of the few units in the country to have milk processing capacity of over 1 million liters a day at a single location. It is the third largest seller of dairy creamers and whiteners in consumer packs after Amul and Nestle. Every month, it ships nearly 9 million sachets of dairy creamers in different SKUs. Other products are skim milk powder, butter, ghee, flavored milk. Among institutional buyers, Umang supplies over 5.5 lakh liters per day of polypowered milk to Mother Dairy for marketing in India. Our other institutional buyers include leading companies like Coca-Cola, Nestle, ITC, Bharti Retail, and Future Group, among many. Our achievements in the year gone by give us justifiable pride and a solid foundation to prepare for the year ahead. However, being alert to the promises and challenges in the world around us, it is an important stating point of these preparations. I now take this opportunity to highlight most significant of them. First and foremost, the year gone by saw adverse currents in currencies and stock markets world over. The Brazilian real, South African rand, Russian rubles, and some of the South Asian currencies all depreciated heavily against dollar. Likewise, the stock market in China, Russia, Brazil, Taiwan lost substantial ground. It's a matter of pride that Indian performance was remarkably better on both of these counts. Credit must be given to the strength of our institutions as well as the Indian economy in ensuring the stability. Crude oil prices dropped from $60 per barrel to $36. So did price of other commodities such as metals, chemicals, and agriculture as well. While this fall brought a welcome relief to the Indian economy by keeping inflation under control, it was not uniformly beneficial everywhere else in the world, giving us a stern reminder of the complexities of navigating business in ever globalizing world. Closer home, several events warned us about becoming complacent and about our past success and favorable circumstances. After winning a big majority of 2014 parliamentary elections, the BJP faced a stiff political challenge in the spectacular victory of Aam Aadmi Party in Delhi and Mahagathbandhan in Bihar state elections. Emboldened by these victories, the opposition parties repeatedly disrupted the working of the parliament, and the last two sessions of the parliament were nearly a total washout, with politics riding on the economic agenda, which held back crucial legislative agendas like GST bill, among others. In the long term, it makes one wonder about the style of governance that our country is headed. As a result, a transition from euphoria to a confrontation marked the policy landscape of the country. Nevertheless, the government did succeed in pushing through several reform measures such as FDI in defense and insurance, and launched several impactful social schemes such as Jan Dhan Yojana and Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. We can expect these initiatives to make a lasting impact on the development of our country and open up new avenues for our businesses. During the course of the year of 2015, for one reason or another, we have seen sparks of communal divide and polarization in the country. There could be actions, reactions, and reaction to reactions. A strong debate has come about on the issue of tolerance and intolerance in the society which occupied in the public eye. We all have to think and understand that our ancient culture of the country is founded on the concept of tolerance, and the issue of communal divide has no place in the thoughts of our country. Therefore, each one of us have to be watchful, hold a candle to enlightened harmony, peace, and economic prosperity of our country as a whole, without any fanatic thought, speech, or action. On a related note, it is saddening to register. Terrorism continues to rock the world. Events in France, USA, Africa, to name a few, were grim reminders of the challenge that global peace faces. These events also remind us about the risk of inequitable growth and equally of continued relevance of the Gandhian principle of peace and non-violence. Put together, it will be fair to say farewell to 2015 as a year which both was taxing time and a testing time for us and our business. Happily, it is also heralds many hopes and promises. The group has made some promising and important beginning in the year gone by, and I see many of them coming to fruition in 2016. Foremost among them is a thrust on digital transformation of our businesses. We have reached out to several experts in this area and have visualized each one of our business processes, particularly manufacturing, logistics, sales being transformed by the impact of digital technology. Small but equally significant beginning has been made in the area of 3D printing. This technology is transforming design and manufacturing in most countries, and I see it as making a defining impact not only on businesses but also as a business capability. Before I close, I would identify for us some significant challenges ahead of us. The first one is climate change. The year 2016 offers new challenges and hopes globally. Climate change is most significant of all. We in India have faced a second successive deficient monsoon, which was particularly characterized by drought in some parts and floods in others, which has shaken the rural economy. Unprecedented rain in Chennai and the floods that followed several affected life in the city, some of our businesses, but more unfortunately, many, including some of the employees, face sudden hardship. However, as usual, all of you and the group companies have risen up to help them in their suffering by making substantial contributions. In the wake of these events, it is reassuring that the world community met together to seal the Paris Climate Agreement. The agreement commits each country to substantially reduce greenhouse gas emissions, a major cause of climate change. Closer home, from beginning of this year, all of us are gathered here today have to adjust to the new traffic regulations being tried on an experimental basis to curb deadly pollution in our city, among several other measures. The options of many would be taxing, but we also have to test our grit and determination to manage under difficult circumstances by the best option that may be available to each one of us. The challenge of pollution is our responsibility, and we have to make sacrifices to overcome its menace. It is very clearly established that if the human race has to survive, we have to be less wasteful, more eco-friendly, more disciplined, and caring for nature. Reaffirming our commitment to this cause, our group companies have also pledged to work towards achieving the goals set out in the agreement. This pledge imposes tremendous responsibility on us to diligently work on a specific initiative to reduce our carbon footprint. I see this as one of the major initiatives in 2016. Another challenge, as well as opportunity, lies in bringing gender diversity in our country. Survey indicates that promoting diversity should be part of strategic agenda of the year ahead. Enabling women to work as equal partners in Indian society and workforce would not only be progressive, but it would also give economy substantial boost. The third challenge and opportunity lies in improving the Human Development Index. HDI is a concern for our country. Towards this, we in our group have been taking several steps to set up medical facilities, educational institutions, and further social causes such as adult literacy and livelihood improvement. I see these initiatives gaining further momentum in the coming years as our obligation to our society. I take this opportunity to urge all of you to also voluntarily contribute your individual time to these initiatives. In our businesses, there will always be challenges confronting us in our mission to excel and provide superior value to our customers, stakeholders, and country at large. I'm confident that NEO will provide much more opportunities than ever before for our experienced minds and energetic youth to prove their mettle, working in tandem with skills of being high. Above everything, optimism and positive thinking should override the burden of challenges. As a humble and learning organization, we should forever be eager to learn, unlearn, relearn, to become more agile to serve the customer even better. Let us strive to be more participative and resolve to inculcate a team spirit. Let us create and share knowledge and wisdom so that it becomes a shared asset. We must believe in ourselves and spread the spirit of confidence and pride. Together, let's rise to challenge and bring together our best in us. With this, I once again wish you and your families a very happy new year. Jai Hind.